Hi my lovely dears, welcome to the 7th tutorial on my channel To Learn Italian. In this tutorial we are going to see some very useful expressions that can be used if you have just started learning a language. So if you don't master it yet, and so sometimes you don't understand what other people say, or if you need somebody to repeat something. And so, let's start with the first situation. So, you need somebody to repeat something. Now, the question to ask to repeat something in Italian is puoi ripetere per favore, which is literally can you repeat please. So we have puoi, which is the second person singular in the present, of course, of the verb potere, which is the Italian for can, be able to, and is an irregular verb, but we will see it in another tutorial. Then ripetere, which is repeat, to repeat, and then per favore, which means please. Now, if you have to be formal, you can use the third person singular of the same verb potere in the present. So the question becomes può ripetere per favore? Now, let's go to another situation. So, if you need somebody to talk more slowly, because you know when somebody talks in his or her mother tongue, tends to talk very quick. So a foreigner, somebody that has just started to learn the language, we go, oh, what does he say? Okay, so the question to ask to talk more slowly is puoi, in we are in informal now, so puoi parlare più lentamente, so which is literally can you talk more slowly please. So we have puoi, so again the verb potere, the second person singular in the present. Then parlare, which is the Italian for to talk, to speak. Then più lentamente, which is literally more slowly. Lentamente is the adverb for lento, which is the Italian for slow. Now, also here, if you have to be formal, then you can use this third person singular, of course, again in the present, of the same verb potere, so può. So the question becomes può parlare più lentamente per favore. Okay, now if you don't understand something that somebody else just say, what you can say is non capisco, which is literally I don't understand, because it's non, so the negation, and then capisco, which is the first person singular of the verb capire, which is the Italian for to understand. Now, more commonly though, we use the past to say that we didn't understand something. So, what you more commonly would say is non ho capito. So, again, non the negation. The verb is again capire, but it's not the present. It's what in Italian we call passato prossimo. So, what in English you would translate with have understood. So, this is all for this tutorial. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Let me know your comments. Feel free to subscribe to the channel, to give a thumb up to the video, and to share it, to do whatever you want. And I hope to see you also for the next tutorial. So I hope that you come and visit us on my channel for the next tutorial. And send you all my love. Ciao, ciao, and thanks for watching.